Hej och välkomna tillbaka till Uniti Update!
So welcome to Uniti Update episode 3. Today we're gonna show you the VR.
And we're gonna show you a yacht.
And a car from India actually.
Way!
And first of all, our team. So let's watch that.
These bad boys.
They will be. Hey!
First of all, we've got some notes on all the teams, what they've been up to this week.
So, the design team.
The design team.
They have been working on a new process for a design iteration. They've been doing the exterior and the interior, and actually getting their designs into the virtual reality simulator.
And printing out some 3D models of it, of course.
They've also sent their 3D sketches for 3D modeling. That's an external job, I believe.
Yeah.
And for you industrial designers out there, they use Alias and Maya and 3DS.
Yeah. Some programs.
Programs, software.
Software.
Then we have the corporate team.
And the corporate team is actually our marketing team and our financial people. So they're looking for governmental funding for our heads-up display and some other things.
So we want to do like a collaboration with an external company for the heads-up display.
So we're trying to work with external parts on that. And new spaces, because we're actually thinking of sizing up the whole place here and to somewhere in Lund or outside of Lund. We're not sure yet.
And that gets us into the engineers.
Engineer team! And these engineers that you see here have actually been looking for machines, and that's why we need a new big space. These machines are in Småland, and that's where they've been to visit and look at them and things like that.
We're not talking the regular drill here. We're talking like a big lathe, a big CNC.
And one last thing they've been working on this week is trying to import an electric car from India, which you will see later on in this episode.
Yeah, stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Moving on to R&D, research and development.
Forskning och utveckling.
They've been researching and developing
a lot of things. So what they've been working on this week is they're working on the robot. So this robot is using different systems to get us one step closer to the autonomous driving system.
And previously this robot has been this size, and they want to scale it up to a big system. And that's also what we mentioned about the electric car from India. It's actually going to be implemented onto that car. So we're going to have an autonomous electric car from India.
Thesis, I don't know what it says here. Yeah, oh, it says thesis work. And they're getting people here to do their theses on different things. And
path planning, I believe. So they want to work out the system on how to choose the route. You know, always lead to Rome, but there's many of them, so you gotta choose one. And that's what they're working on, basically.
And they've also been working on something called a PID speed control.
And that's like a control system. It's basically, if you accelerate, you can either make the motor go full speed instantly or like more ramp up to speed. And you need to trim that so it's safely but still feels nice. You want a bit of acceleration in the back when you accelerate.
And so that was everything. Yeah. So that was everything for our teams, and now we're going to answer a question that we got last week.
First of all, thank you for your engagement. We love this, and please, if you're watching and you have a question or a thought or something you would like to see in the episodes, please ask.
So Finjack Lee asked, you should show a little bit more of the VR scene. Could you please show more like driving in the VR? And we thought that'd be great.
Thing is, we have two different virtual reality simulators. The first one we call the Kepper Pod, like you see here, and it actually has handles. And this one was used to drive around in.
And this was to test a dynamic environment in the car. However, now that we're building the prototype, it's a little bit obsolete. So we moved on to actually working on a new VR, and it's static.
SVT was here. That's the largest television channel in Sweden. And they were trying the virtual reality simulator that we just built. So we thought we could show you when they were here and trying it out.
Ett helt nytt skånskt bilmärke kan snart bli verklighet. Och målet är en liten elektrisk stadsbil för kortare resor.
And so here you can see one of the SVT journalists trying it out. And here you can see we test the interfaces and things like that. And you can see the whole interior and you can actually walk around the car.
Uniti försöker skapa framtidens bil genom att utmana den gigantiska bilindustrin.
Om man tittar på motorväg eller landsväg idag i Sverige, så de som åker till jobbet, det är en person i en bil som har 5 säten, som väger 2 ton, som har en maskin som var utvecklad på början av 1900-talet. Och det är väl det vi vill ändra, att vi vill ha ett mindre format, lättare format och någonting som passar för den tid vi lever i idag.
And so that was the SVT clip. It was super fun being in the news on the Swedish channel SVT. It's one of the largest channels in Sweden, and it was super great coverage.
Yeah, so that was the TV. Cool. Have your grandparents watched that?
I don't have grandparents.
Oh, sorry.
Why you never asked that question?
No. So?
Well, now. And now we're gonna go on to India. And why are we going on to India?
So the previous prototype for the autonomous driving platform is small, but our car is gonna be big. So we want to try stuff on a big scale system. That's why we need an electric car. It could be any car. It just needs four wheels and electric motors. So we figured we'll buy one from Bangalore, India.
So we actually acquired a full-scale electric car from India through one of our engineers here at Uniti, Rudy. And Rudy's going to talk a little bit of the process of getting the electric car. So Rudy, what stages have you had during the process?
Firstly, we had a lot of discussions in the office,
mm-hmm.
Where we had to decide on what kind of chassis that we should have to build a mule car, and everybody were open to give their opinions on what kind of chassis we should have. We had to go for a compact car, which we can buy for a cheaper price. And then we thought of importing a car from India. And
okay, so who are the people that have actually helped us getting it?
Yeah, we had like my childhood friends and schoolmates who were there studying with me in India.
Yeah.
And they have been following us since I know Uniti. Because as I loved it, I told them that this is an interesting project that's being done in Uniti, mm-hmm. Sweden. Yeah.
Cool. And that's, now we're going to see a clip from the whole process and Rudy's friends in Bangalore.
Hey, what's up, Nikki?
So that was the car. It's on its way now to Sweden.
But it doesn't actually have batteries because the weight is a little too much and it's heavy and not so cost efficient. So Isak actually had an idea on how to get new batteries.
We could buy new ones. It would be very expensive and also not as good for the environment. So instead, so I have a friend that works on a yacht, and this yacht is actually replacing its batteries. And we could use them batteries. Even though they're replacing them, they're not terribly bad. They still work good enough for a prototype.
So let's watch the yacht.
Please come on board.
Should we go down and see what's happening there? See if we can get one of these out. So the prototype would need eight of these.
How much do they weigh?
50 kilos.
I said some. Maybe?
That was the yacht there, as you saw. It's a huge boat, in other words.
Diesel, though. We want
diesel.
To. We have some work to do on
yeah. Both the boat inside,
yeah.
But we'll start with cars anyways.
Yeah.
So now we're actually getting the car and the batteries here at the office, and we're going to mount them together and then get our autonomous system up and running on full scale. So that's going to be something cool.
I think that was it for this week.
And so if you have any questions or comments or things like that you'd like to see more of or anything like that, please do feel free to comment below and we'll try to respond to them.
And if you're having car problems, Uniti 8-1. Hit me.